Coming up next on Fit for Duty, we're in the weight room.
First exercise we're gonna do is we're gonna do barbell squats. Now I want his base nice and wide, push up on those heels, nice straight back, slight bend. For this segment, we're gonna focus on shoulders. Good, is that eight? Welcome to Fit for Duty. I'm Master Sergeant Mike Skaggs, and I have from the Air Force Honor Guard, A1C Matt Atchison. We're here at Bowling Air Force Base, and we're gonna do a strength training workout in this first segment for our lower body. Matt, are you ready? All right, first exercise we're gonna do is we're gonna do barbell squats. Now, I really want you to listen to me at home as I walk Matt through this exercise. I see this done wrong in a lot of cases, but Matt, he's got the wisdom of me with him. He's gonna do all these right. So Matt, I want you to kind of step into the bar, get underneath your shoulder. This bar is gonna rest right in the back of his neck. He's gonna go ahead and lift up, walk back a little bit away from the thing. All right, now I want his base nice and wide. We don't have too much weight on here. If you need more weight, add more weight. General strength training, 8 to 12 reps, 2 to 3 sets, that's where we're going. Now Matt, I want you to throw your butt back towards me when you come down, all the way down to 90 degrees and push up with those heels, just like that. Stop right before you lock out your knees. Now, come down again. Let's try that again. Push up on those heels. Right there, stop. Don't lock those knees out. Go ahead, there's two. Now, if you're following along at home, we've got our weight evenly distributed throughout the foot here. Toes aren't coming off the ground. The knees aren't going out over the toes. And he's pushing with those heels to kind of drive it up. This is a great lower body exercise. We're working quads, hamstrings, glutes. Nice straight back, slight bend. He's got his spine in that ready position. Where are we at, Matt? There's seven. Remember, 8 to 12, there was eight. Head and neck stay neutral here. Bar resting right there. Great form, Matt. Nice tight abs. There's 10. Two more. How are those legs feeling, Matt? 11. Don't lock those knees out. Try not to pop them out. Lower and up, up, up. Go ahead and put the weight back in the rack. We'll give it a break. Again, 7 second tempo here on all of our repetitions. 3 seconds down, slight pause. 3 seconds up. 1 second pause at the bottom, that's seven. Math, that's math for me, West Virginia math, it counts, right? We did it, right? All right, so again, this is a great compound exercise. We got hip extension, knee extension, great quadricep, hamstring, gluteus, lower back. You feel all those muscles working there, keep that core nice and tight when we go down, and Matt's gonna have legs that he can put shorts on next time you see him on Fit for Duty, okay? All right, Matt, let's go ahead and get that weight back on our shoulders again. Now, this is the most tricky part about doing squats. Go ahead and come up. It's coming back out of this thing. Nice thing. Your spotter at home, your buddy's spotting you in the gym. Jay's standing right behind you. All right, Matt, go ahead and throw the back towards me and down. Now, as I spot him, I'm doing the exercise with him. I've got him right here at the waist. If he has problems, I can come up here. And Matt and I are gonna do this exercise together. Great form here, by the way. Notice he gets 90 degrees, doesn't go any lower than that, and that knee stays behind the toe. This is key. Nice, slow repetitions, and don't lock those knees out at the top. What number are we on, Matt? Okay, this is seven. Again, I want these knees staying back here. I see the knees go way out over the toes, and people come up on their heels or on the ball of their feet, and the heels don't stay on the ground. You've got to push through with those heels and really tighten up those gluteus muscles as you come up. We on 10 yet? 11, one more. Great. Go ahead and rack it. That's 12. Great compound exercises. Guys, if you're not doing squats, you are missing out on so much. This is such a great exercise. It builds muscles in so many areas, even in your upper body with your core. It's a great core strengthening exercise if you're doing these right. I hear a lot of times, oh, I've got bad knees, I can't do these. Just don't do as much weight. You do them correctly, it's not gonna bother your knees. All right, next exercise we're gonna do, Matt, an know you want to hear this, more squats, except this time we're going with dumbbells. I'm going to throw a little twist in it. So Matt, what I want you to do is I want you to grab the dumbbells and I want you to come shoulder width apart here and I want you to hold the dumbbells right at your side, okay? As Matt grabs the dumbbells, go ahead and back up a little bit right there. Feet shoulder width apart. Now what I'm going to do here with the medicine ball is I'm going to force Matt to kind of work the inner part of his thighs here. That's his abductor muscles, or his adductor muscles. So squeeze this ball with your inner thighs. All right, now I want you to go into your squat. Again, same form here. Throw that butt back, Matt. Knees don't go out over the toes. And you see this adds a little degree of difficulty here while he's focusing on squeezing that ball and really coming up. He's really going to find his abductor and adductor muscles are working well with this. So as a, go ahead and keep going. I can see he's having a little bit of trouble here. Don't lock out those knees. Come down, stop, and come up. Nice slow repetition. We ready to get the ball back in there. Squeeze. Squeeze it. Squeeze your knees. Now come up. All right, good. Where are we at? There's 10. Keep that head and neck up. There's 11. Keep those knees back from the toes. And there's 12. Go ahead and drop the ball. Set the weights down. A little bit of break. See the difference? Did you feel the difference in that, Matt? If you're doing that at home, you don't even need a medicine ball. That's what we have here. If your kids got a play ball around or something like that, you can have that. Just squeeze those thighs together. And when you come down, that really forces tension in those muscles. And again, that's the key component to strength training, is time under tension with those muscles. We do one more set of these squats. Again, 2 to 3 sets at home, 8 to 12 reps, general strength training purposes. If you don't have enough weight on there, get more. If you're not having muscle failure at the end, you need to increase your weight. And if you can't get to 8 to 12, then you need to decrease your weight. Fair enough, Matt? All right, Matt, one more set of the dumbbell squats. Again, these are really good for those outer thighs and inner thighs, especially when we throw this ball in. Matt may not know it today, but I guarantee you tomorrow he's going to say, wait a minute, I tried something different. All right, so go ahead and start your squat, Matt. I want you to come down. I'm going to put the ball in there right at your bottom. Squeeze. Now, come up. Good. Matt's head and neck are staying neutral here. He's throwing that butt back. If there was a chair, Matt would be sitting in his chair without falling out. That's okay. Keep going, Matt. Just means we'll work on those a little more. If you can't do it with the ball in there, that's fine. Just use the dumbbells. You're still going to feel that on the outer thighs. Again, feet are staying flat on the floor. His knees aren't going below 90 degrees. And Matt's coming right up. All right, Matt, what is that? Is that 9? All right, there's 10. I want to get 2 more with that ball in there with him. So when you come down on this one, squeeze. Now come up. Come on, give me 1. You got 1 more after that. That's actually 13, but that's okay. We're going to cheat it out a little bit. And there you go. Let's drop the ball. Go ahead and set the dumbbells down over here. Again, if you haven't done this exercise, guys, we're guilty of doing upper body all the time, what I like to call show muscles. Do that lower body, put some shorts on. Don't be embarrassed, okay? Matt, next one we're going to do is a hip extension. So I want you to grab the bar here. Set it down. Now, Matt, what I want here, I want you just to grab the bar somewhere in the middle, and I want it nice and tight back up here. And you're going to bend, keep this bar right along the thighs and come up and squeeze those gluteus, okay? Not a deadlift. We don't bend that lower back. The back stays nice and straight. Matt's feet are shoulder width apart. Go ahead and come up. Now, I want that right on the thigh. Now, you're going to bend over. Bend over at the waist and come up. Okay, here's what I want to see, Matt. One more time, I'm going to just roll the barbell along. Back's up straight. You bend over at the back and come up just like that, okay? If you don't have the form down, this is not a normal exercise we're doing. That's fine. You see how I coach Matt right through this exercise, so go ahead and roll it right around the thighs. Good. Now roll it up. Good. Keep that bar right along the thighs and come up. What I want you to focus on is squeezing this gluteus maximus here when you come up. Head and neck stay neutral. Slide it right along there, Matt, and right up. Just bend over at the waist. Good. Keep those knees straight. I want knees straight. There you go. Perfect. Good. Just like that. And again, notice how I coached Matt right through the weak part of this exercise. His head and neck are staying up. Kind of keep it right here, Matt, and squeeze that gluteus. You're going to feel this in your hamstrings. I guarantee you, if you haven't been doing this exercise at home, you're going to feel this in your hamstrings the next day. How many do we have, Matt? 11, and 12. Go ahead and set it down. Now, when you're doing this exercise at home, again, those feet stay shoulder width apart. I keep that bar right along my thighs, and I roll it down, bending over at the waist, and then I stand it up, and I concentrate on squeezing my gluteus and my hamstrings when I come up, okay? It's gonna look like this one more time, man. The bar's right on my thing. Shoulders are rolled back, head and neck stay neutral. Let's bend over at the waist, and I come up just like that. All right? That's the way your form needs to look at home as you're doing these. This is a great glute builder. Ladies, I know we love these butt-burning exercises. This is a great exercise for that. Okay, man, let's go. Bend over at the waist and come up. Not quite a deadlift. The shoulders are back, his head and neck are staying neutral, and he rolls that bar right along the front of his thighs and comes up and squeezes the glutes. There's five. You feeling that back there, Matt? Tomorrow, he's really gonna feel this in his hamstrings, probably right about the center of them. It's a great exercise, and you're gonna feel this in your gluteus, especially when you go climb those stairs a day or two after doing this exercise. We're doing good. We're gonna continue doing this. We'll see you after the break.
Today, I'd like to talk about running bare. Barefoot, that is.
Welcome back from the break. We're finishing our workout on shoulders and legs. For this segment, we're gonna focus on shoulders. I've switched subjects. I've got A1C Dominic Nat. He's gonna work his shoulders with me. We're gonna call him Dom, because that's what he prefers. Dom, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, for this first exercise, we've got a straight bar, and we're gonna do a frontal raise. Now, Dom, what I want you to do, as I coach you through this, I want you to just bend down at the knees, pick up the bar, bring it up, safety first, and then you're just gonna raise straight up to about eye level and down right before it hits your thighs. And come up again. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Want those feet shoulder width apart. Keep that neck and head straight ahead in the neutral position. And go ahead and go. Head and neck up, straight up. Not quite that high, and down. Stop right there. Stop right there. There. Again, we're going for strength training here. That's 2 to 3 sets, 8 to 12 reps. So pick that weight. 1 minute rest in between. I can see Dom shaking already. What are we on, 6? There's 7. Again, this is focusing on our anterior deltoid. We have an anterior, medial, and posterior deltoid. These anteriors are really being worked when we do our bench press. So this, if you want to improve your bench press some, this is a great exercise. Doesn't take a lot of weight. Dom's got his elbows nice and straight, but not locked. Is that 10? Okay, go ahead and set the weight down. We've done our 12. Again, we're going to get that minute rest. Like I've said before, I want you to have a nice wide base. Go ahead and put your feet together, Dom. I want you to stand with your feet together. The reason we want that nice wide base is because he has some balance issues here. Go ahead and spread your feet a little bit. If I go there, it's much easier to catch your balance, Dom. And that's why you should always, always, always get those feet about shoulder width apart. Create that nice base. Get that back ready to go. Keep that head and neck neutral. Never compromise the spine. Keep following those tips at home. I guarantee you won't go wrong in the weight room. You see it done wrong a lot. Next time you can go up to a guy and say, hey, you ever thought about this? All right, Dom, we ready? Next set. All right, let's get one more set in here. We're going to focus medial, anterior, deltoids here with this workout. Good. Just like that. Now, he keeps that right about eye level. Don't go too high. We don't want to over rotate that shoulder. It's a good weight. You can see Dom starting to shake right now. Where are we at? Is that 6? Okay, there's 7. If I'm spotting him, I'll just come around front. There's 8. Come on. There's 9. Great. 10. 2 more. Keep going. 11. Remember, exhale and inhale. Nice, slow, purposeful movements here. I'm going to take the weight from him. 7-second repetitions, 3 seconds up, 3 seconds down, 1 second rest in between with that slight pause. Dom, feel those anterior deltoids, got a good workout. All right, good. Now we're going to that medial deltoid. I said we have a front, middle, and back, or anterior, medial, and posterior deltoid. We hit the anterior, let's go with that medial. For these, moderate weight, about 15 pounds. Dom, I want you to stand with your shoulder. Your feet shoulder width apart, get that head and neck neutral, and you just come straight up and down right before it touches, okay? All right, so Dom's gonna take the dumbbells, get those feet shoulder width apart, create that nice stable base, get that head and neck neutral, Get ready, get in the ready position. All right, go ahead, Dom. Bring it up right there and down. Stop right there. There's one. Elbows are nice and straight, but not locked, as straight as possible. And the reason it takes just a light weight here is because, first of all, these muscles aren't very big. Secondly, this is a very compromised joint in this exercise. Think of a stick. If you had a long stick and you put a heavy weight at the end and tried to raise it up like that, that stick would be very weak in the middle. The same thing goes with your elbow, so nice light weight here. Dom, where are we at? 11, one more, and 12. Go ahead and set those weights down. Let them rest. You know, if you want to stretch your shoulder, you can do that in between, you know. But we're focusing on all that, the deltoid. Doesn't take a lot of work here, a lot of weight to work these deltoids. We're going to go to a little heavier weight on our next exercise, but still we got one more set of these, right?
Yep.
Feeling like your shoulders are getting a good workout now. Hope you're following along at home. You've probably seen these exercises done before, but the key to what I'm teaching you here is form, form, form. Form is the most important thing that you can do in the weight room. It prevents injuries. It may not be instantaneous if you have bad form, but it can be cumulative, and you'll get injured as you go on. So we really want to focus on that form. Time under tension with that muscle, key component, intensity. That's what we like to call it. All right, Dom, let's pick them up. Let's go for one more set here on these anterior deltoids. Feet shoulder width apart, those muscles nice and tight, and go ahead and lift. I'm gonna go ahead and lift up Dom's shirt here so you can see right here is the muscle group you're focusing on, right? And if I'm gonna spot Dom, I'm gonna come around behind him, and I'm just gonna give him a little bit of assist from behind here. I'm always gonna make sure that he's got the right form. Slow it down just a little bit. Good. Is that 8? Good, count them out. Nice, slow, purposeful movements here. We're watching for form. Anytime he gets sloppy with his form, we're gonna go ahead and stop the exercise. That means he's getting tired. How many, 2 more? 1, slow it down. Lower, 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 just like that, okay? Go ahead and lower the weight. Again, lower, if I slow down that tempo some when I'm lowering the weight, that negative, I get more out of the exercise. And really, none of us have a lot of time to be spending in the weight room. I know I don't, a lot of people don't. So if you really maximize your time in there, and that's getting good contractions on the eccentric and concentric portion, and keep that time under tension, you're gonna get the most out of your workout, a little bit of time, and you'll find out you don't have to do as much in there. I say if you spend more than 20 minutes on a body part in the weight room, you're wasting your time. All right, Dom, one more exercise. You guys have seen this done 1,000 times. It's an overhead press. We're gonna do it with a little variation. What I wanna do is I wanna split stance here. See, they come up. Elbows stay at 90 degrees, and he presses up and brings it down, all right? I like to do a military press with dumbbells versus a barbell because I don't have to compromise my spinal cord by moving my head and neck. Dom, we're not gonna do that today. So go ahead and pick up the dumbbells, get in that split stance. Let's get ready to do our overhead press. This works both the anterior, medial, and the posterior deltoid. Good. Good. Elbows stay right at 90 degrees. I'm back here to spot him. That's 5, right? 6. Straight up. Don't lock that elbow out. Slow it down just a little bit. 7, slow. 8. Can hear his shoulders popping just a little bit. 9. Why don't you give me 2 more? 10. Slow. 11. Go ahead and set him down, Dom. Rest. You can see Dom shaking there a little bit. That's fine. That means he's getting a little bit tired towards the end of the set, which is what you want. That means you have the correct amount of weight there. And when you start to lose that form, just quit the exercise and pick it up again after you get about a minute's rest, okay? Form is a key component again. Injury prevention, injury prevention, injury prevention. Dom, how the shoulders feel? Guys, it's not gonna take a lot of weight or a lot of work to do a good shoulder workout. This is a great little shoulder routine. It's great for the whole shoulder. I can't say enough about this. Just 3 exercises here. We're doing 6 sets on the show. I want you to try to do 9 sets, 2 to 3 sets, 8 to 12 reps, and we're gonna be good to go. Dom, we're ready to start. One more set. If you're following along at home, you got one more. Again, let's split that stance up a little bit. I want 1 foot back and 1 foot forward. All right, bring those weights out. All right, go ahead and go. One, slow it down. Two, 7 second repetitions here. Three, four, good. Five, six, good job, Dom. Notice that head and neck are staying neutral. Eight, we're gonna finish up this set. You keep going at home, we'll see you and come back after break. So, nine, come on, Dom, 10.
I'm Commander Dave Keblish, orthopedic surgeon and team physician for the U.S. Naval Academy. Today, I'd like to talk about running bare, barefoot that is. In the world of long distance running, there's a growing interest in minimalist shoe wear or running with no shoes at all. Lately, many patients have asked my opinion on the topic. Much of the interest has been generated by Christopher McDougall's best-selling book, Born to Run, and a variety of new shoes on the market like the Vibram Five Fingers. First, let me say, it's a fun book, and it raises some interesting points, and that I own a pair of Five Fingers. I just don't like running in them. The theory behind all this hype is the assertion that one, humans are genetically built to run long distances, and two, that expensive running shoes actually cause more injuries than they prevent. In Born to Run, the author cites an example of ancient tribe of Native Americans that commonly run over 100 or 200 miles in just a few days. Similar to certain African tribesmen, they are known to hunt down large game by running them to death. Barefoot. Barefoot running enthusiasts claim that our feet are becoming weak because the fancy arch supports and thick cushions in the modern shoes do all the work. They say that if we ran barefoot or in minimalist shoe wear, basically little more than moccasins, we would naturally become more nimble and get more up onto the balls of our feet, utilizing a more efficient running style. I'm a fan of midfoot strike running. However, I object to the notion that all humans were born to be great runners or that running shoes cause more injuries than they prevent. Together, let's train smart and stay strong.
Hope you enjoyed today's workout for your shoulders and legs. We'd like to thank Bowling Air Force Base for letting us use this fine fitness center. I'd like to thank the Air Force Honor Guard for providing me with today's trainees, Dom and Matt. I know they enjoyed their workout. I hope you did at home. And we'll see you next time on Fit for Duty.